The Epic of Gabriel and Jibril. Gabriel lived with his father in a big house, surrounded by other big houses. His mother died the night he was born. He spent his time alone, reading or playing electronic games. Once, Gabriel said to his father that it would be better to have a small house and a mother instead of a big house and no mother. His father's reply was that life is not fair. Gabriel and his father used to go to the beach every weekend, although his dad mumbled that the beach was not the same anymore. Gabriel knew what his father meant. He meant the people who built strange houses there. The townies called them refugees. Gabriel knew his father did not like these people. He heard him and his friends discussing angrily how to get rid of them. That's why he never revealed his secret. Every Sunday, his dad gave the nanny a day off and drove Gabriel and himself to the beach. He stayed in the car, texting or talking to his friends, and let Gabriel explore the area. The kid loved combing the surroundings. He found rocks, driftwood sculptures, and seashells. One day, he went to visit a little bay behind a patch of trees and came across some houses made out of cardboard, wooden planks, and tin sheets. That's where he met Jibril. Jibril showed him his home and Gabriel loved it. The house was a boat turned upside down and it contained only two sleeping bags, clothes, and some plates and forks. Jibril said it was in this boat that they crossed the sea. With tears in his eyes, he shared that his mum drowned when they were thrown in the water during a storm. Before she died, she shouted to his dad to leave her and save Jibril no matter what. Jibril was proud of his father, who delivered pizza every day, including weekends, to save money for food. Jibril spent his time alone, mostly making pictures in the sand or washing his and his father's clothes in the nearby brook. He didn't mind. His father told him that life is not fair. Gabriel was fascinated by his new friend and his story. Jibril was also intrigued by his newfound buddy. He tried to imagine his house, his electronic gadgets, and his room full of toys. They continued to meet every weekend secretly, and only in Jibril's house. Gabriel's father would never allow him to bring kids like Jibril to their home or to play with them. Usually, Gabriel was given 1 hour for fun on the beach. Immediately after he left his father in the car, he rushed to the little bay behind the patch of trees. One day, while running to Jibril's house, he thought that flying was better than walking. He created a short poem about it and shared it with his friend. Jibril liked it. He wrote the verse on a sheet of paper and pinned the sheet on the wall next to his sleeping bag. The poem said, "I am the boy. I am the boy. I am the boy who flattened millions of ants, just learning to walk." Another day, Gabriel brought a gift to his friend, his old phone, so they could play together. Often, he bought Jibril his favorite cloud-shaped cookies. They both dreamt of flying, of becoming pilots. One weekend, they found instructions on the internet that explained how to build a digital aircraft using a household item as a base. They decided that Jibril's house had the perfect body for an aircraft. It had an elongated shape and room for two pilots. Gabriel took a photo of the boat with his phone. Being good with words, he suggested the airplane be called Phoenix, the bird of paradise. As Jibril liked to draw, he turned the boat from the photograph into an airplane and colored it white, while his friend browsed the web for propellers, engines, and wings. Gabriel came up with the idea that they would fly as fast as angels, leaving everything else in the dust. He laughed and said that angels probably fly fast because they take themselves lightly. Jibril also laughed and said that they would like to be intergalactic angels, one with dark and one with blonde hair. They had a lot of fun creating their two-seater airplane. On the last weekend before Gabriel started school, The two friends realized that during their previous encounters, they had accomplished a lot and the airplane was ready to take off. That day, Gabriel was given 2 full hours to play. His father told him to climb the hill that was far away from the little bay behind the patch of trees and to enjoy the fireworks. He also told him it was a special day because he was organizing a spectacular event with his friends. Earlier that evening, the two airplane builders added the finishing touches to their gadget. On their phone screens, the airplane looked fabulous in 3 dimensions, especially with a blue sky behind it. Jibril had a surprise for his friend. He showed Gabriel a drawing of the name he created the previous day. The name Phoenix was painted in big white letters. If Gabriel approved, it would be put on the fuselage. Gabriel made thumbs up gesture and said the mark was cool and fit perfectly. Both of them were of the same opinion that white letters were ideal because they were almost invisible on the white surface of the plane. They had just positioned the graphics on their screens when they heard a big bang, an explosion of some kind. The two of them jumped out from Jibril's house and immediately rushed back in. The air outside was full of tension and fire and smoke. Gabriel saw some of his father's friend pouring liquid on the little dwellings before disappearing in the dark. Detonations came from everywhere. People were crying, screaming, and shouting. It became very hot, even in the boathouse. For a few seconds, the poem from the wall zigzagged in the air like an ignited butterfly. Burning plastic was dripping from the ceiling and glowing pieces were flying from everywhere. The sleeping bags turned into 2 hot puddles. It became difficult to breathe. Their clothes started to melt. The 2 kids were shaken. They hugged and crawled in the corner with eyes wide open and "what is this all about" looks on their faces. Before it collapsed, the boat shook violently. Gabriel and Jibril held hands. In that moment, 2 powerful engines started to roar. 2 propellers began rotating wildly, and 2 airplane wings waved goodbye to somebody.